Okay guys, today we are going to be going through isometric projection, and I'm going to be creating this isometric drawing here, which consists of a cube and a cylinder on top of it. Right. So far you need your 60-30 set square and pixels. I've started this here. So I'm just going to re-emphasize the shape. Thought the shape was a bit too light, so I'm just going to re-emphasize it so you guys at home can see. This side here is 48 centimeters, and the vertical comes in at 36 centimeters. So all verticals, 36. This is a cube, not directly a cube, because all the sides aren't equal. So this is a rectangle. Good. So we have something there that everyone can see what we are doing. Okay, follow. Now, what we need to do is we need to put in this opening. We need to put in this opening. Right here. So first thing, from this point here, I'm going to step in 14 millimeters on both sides. Then I go up 24, like we know, we draw the line first and then we come back and we measure. So you just draw that line roughly. Then we come here 24, yeah. Then we put in this back line to show the three-dimensional aspect of it. So far we've completed our rectangle. It looks good, it's nice and clean. And now what we're going to do, we're going to go onto the cylinder. But first, before we go onto the cylinder, we need to create a box for the cylinder. The cylinder comprises of a circle, which is 34 diameter. We are here, and I just want the audience to see that the cylinder comprises of a circle which is 34 millimeters diameter, and it is 24 millimeters tall. So first thing, to achieve this, we need to create a square in here. And to achieve that, we first need to find out the center point. So I'm just going to do all this little madness just to try and find out my center point. So we know that this is 48 across, so I can come here and look for 24, which is half of 48. 24 here, and we know that once again this is 48 there. Yeah. Just let me correct, this is a cube. Is it? Because all the sides aren't actually equal. It has a height of 36. But this top face is 48 by 48 with a height of 36, so it's not quite a cube. Let's just call it a rectangle, so as not to get ourselves in any problem. So now, if this circle here is 34, if this circle here is 34, question is that I'm going to ask myself, how are we going to then set up this triangle? sorry, set up this square, with each side reflects that this whole circle is 34. What do we do? We know half of 34 is something like 17.5. Let me just verify that. 34 divided by 2, 2 into 3 is 1, remainder 1, 2 into 14 is 7, remainder 1, that's 17.5. So we come here at our center point that we have established, where we offset north, south, west, east, 17.5. It's going to be hard for you guys to find 17.5. So the best thing, it's going to be hard for you guys to find 17.5, so probably the best thing is just to call it 17. Okay, good, now we have identified where the 17.5 marker would be, and then just now creating the internal square. Okay, good. So let's give our square some point names. So we call here A, B, C, and D. Now, the first thing we need to do in creating this isometric circle, we need to bring a line through the longest points, the longest opposite points, which are A and C. So I'm going to correspond a line from A to C going through the midpoint. Like that, just like that. Next thing is A to B has a midpoint, so I'm going to call this midpoint 1, and D to C has a midpoint, and I'm going to call that midpoint 2. The next step is D goes up to midpoint 1, so we correspond D to midpoint 1, and then midpoint 2 to B. This is the formula, and what has happened now is two points have been created. This is our first point here. This is our second point. Points 1 and 2 sit opposite each other, and those are necessary in creating the isometric circle, and we need two more points. Points 3 and point B share the same location. Point 4 and B share the same location. So now we have that in, we can actually plot now our circle, which we will be able to get in our first circle here. But instead of doing that, I'm going to actually transfer this information up 24 millimeters high, so that we can plot both circles at the same time. So I'm just going to transfer all of this information down here. 24 millimeters high. As the usual, we draw first and then measure after. For those of you who just joined and wondering what am I doing, I'm creating an isometric projection. And this isometric projection is a rectangle with a cylinder on top. And right now I'm actually putting in the construction lines for the circle. The asymmetric circle, of course, that is. Guys, you guys, when you're doing this construction, you use a really light pencil so that you can actually see your constructions and they don't actually confuse you from your real lines, right? It's just my advice I'm gonna give. Seeing that we're only looking for specific points, I'm only bringing up specific points that I'm actually going to use in this construction. So we can call this A, B, C, and D also. And you know, D goes up to the midpoint one. And we know B goes to the midpoint two. So we have, this is our top point, one, point two, three, and four. So we can actually plot now. I would like a compass. Can I get a compass? Thank you. So let's plot. I'm going to start with the top one. So you guys see. So one starts here at this point, and then it goes around and it creates an arc.
Sorry.
And it ends. Keep this compass open to the same distance, and we stab two. And two is just the opposite to one. So we create the same curve. Alright. Now we go to three. We stab three and we pick back up the curve from where we started at one. And we connect it all the way to two. And then we do the opposite at 4, which is also point B. So that's that. So far we have seen the top cylinder in, and now we need to do the bottom one. I found it easier to do the top one first and then work like this so that you guys can see that you can actually draw the construction first and then actually plot after. Some students try to do circle one and then come and do another circle, but I like to do all my construction first, so when I'm finished the construction I move straight in to execution. We've already set up and we just move freely. I think it's smoother too. Right, so what am I doing? I'm now putting the last bit to complete this isometric circle. This isometric circle is now complete.
Are you paying attention?
It's a video you need to know. The people will hear you.
So the isometric circle is now completed. And this isometric projection is also complete too. Just profiling what I've done.
I'm not sure.
Okay guys, so here we have it. We have an isometric projection which has an isometric cylinder and an isometric rectangle. Cylinder sits directly on top of the rectangle. So that's it. Signing off guys. I hope you enjoyed this. possibly you have to go back through this video and pause at various points so that you make sure you get all the steps. Thank you.